said, on September 20th, Hurricane Maria reached Puerto Rico. The storm knocked out power to the entire island, and a majority of the population is unable to access clean water. 16 people were killed during the hurricane. Although the storm has passed, Puerto Rico is still facing many repercussions of the destruction left in Hurricane Maria's wake. Puerto Rico's sole energy source was knocked out, and the power supply was shut off to 100% of its customers. Power may not be fully restored for another 6 months. Hospitals and other medical centers are being powered by generators, and according to the FDA, drug shortages are possible because power outages in Puerto Rico have stopped or limited production at many medicine factories. The FDA commissioner, Scott Gottlieb, I don't really know how to pronounce his last name, came out with a statement saying that they are working to prevent such shortages, but he didn't specify like what exactly his plan was when questioned further on the subject. Within the last decade, the population of Puerto Rico has begun to decline. Many of the residents there have been moving to the mainland United States for better economic opportunities for themselves and their families. According to CNN, this decrease in population leaves the territory with few skilled workers to handle the rebuilding and development process. Also, Puerto Rico, I think in 2010, came out with declared bankruptcy, and it was like the largest declaration of bankruptcy in like the United States. Thankfully, there are a variety of relief efforts helping the people of Puerto Rico, but again, as Jacob said, unfortunately, the destruction of bridges and roads has made it difficult for aid to reach certain areas. The Red Cross, however, has mobilized relief supplies, including 20,000 comfort kits, 6,000 blankets, 5,000 cleanup kits, 8,000 tarps, as well as thousands of flashlights and batteries. There is also 450 volunteer and like paid Red Cross workers in Puerto Rico right now. So what can we do? In my environmental management class, we talked a lot about the hurricane. It was like a big topic of discussion. And what my professor recommended to us, and I'm gonna spread the word to you guys, is to, if you have the means, donate money. Anything helps, and do your research. There are so many charitable organizations currently trying to raise funds to help the people of Puerto Rico. Donate blood. This is a big deal. A lot of blood drives and stuff have been sending a lot of their donations to things like Las Vegas recently, and so none of it is being passed on to Puerto Rico. So if you can donate blood, do. In fact, we have a lot of blood drives on campus throughout the year. There was one yesterday in the Santa Lucia Residence Hall. Did any of you guys go to that? No? Well, next time. Lastly, spread the word. A well-informed and educated public increases the chances of individuals to get out and help.